want?
Justice.
When do we want it?
Now.
What do we want?
Justice.
When do we want it?
Now.
What do we want?
Justice.
Justice for who?
Justice for our side.
Justice for who?
Justice for our side.
Never forget.
Never forget.
Never forget.
Never forget.
Our next speaker will be Councilman JUMAANE Williams.
It's frozen.
Good afternoon, everybody.
Good afternoon.
I'm very happy to see so many people not understanding why the whole city isn't here. This is not controversial in the least. This is about justice. There's nothing controversial ever about justice. But I often think about when I bring up race and other people bring up race, and they always say, you're always pulling the race card. As if me describing the problem is worse than the problem that exists. And I remember, I think it was the Duke lacrosse team. They said that they raped a young black woman. And the man that tried to accuse him of that was fired. Who was fired? With four or five white young men. 25 years ago, in 1989, I believe I was 9, 10, 11, about 12. 12 years old. They were calling them wolf pack. They were calling them animal. And they looked like me. My mother, who's here in the audience today, thank God, let me know my history, that I was not an animal, that I was not part of some wolf pack. What about the 13, 14, 15-year-olds that may not have had that and see that repeatedly on the TV screen, that the animals and the wolf packs, what about them? Donald Trump bought a full-page ad calling them wolf packers and have a death penalty. We can't even get a line saying I'm sorry right now.
Yeah,
then the Wolfstein, Robert Morgenthau careers were made. They should be criminalized right now. Why are they not arrested for what they did on purpose of what happened here?
That's right.
Don't tell me it's a race card. If they were not people who had melanin in their skin, one, they would not have been arrested 25 years ago. Two, their rights as 14, 15, 16-year-old children would not have been violated. Three, they would not have been convicted. Four, they would not have waited 25 years. And five, they would have a check cut already.
That's right.
It is because they are black and brown that we are here today. And anybody that thinks that is something different, you are lying to yourselves.
That's right.
And that's what sickens me. Not only do you put us in this situation, when we talk about it, you blame us for bringing it up.
Yep.
These young men had half of their lives taken from them for a crime they did not commit. I remember the whole city was against them. I was like, oh Lord, they probably shouldn't have done it. They did not do it. A man said, I did it, and there was evidence that he did it, and he was convicted. They were free. Cut the check. I got nothing else to say.
That's right. Cut the check. Cut the check.
I'm sick and tired of being sick and tired.
Okay, that's right.
25 years. It's been an eternity. We've been going through this too long. I was 14 years old at the time. Raymond was 14. Yusef was 15. Antron was 15. Corby was 16. We were kids.
Right.
Now we're adults and we're still going through this.
Yep.
We're hearing the same thing over and over. When is it going to stop? Three simple words. We want closure. We want to put a period to this ever-long sentence. We want this thing to stop. We've been going through this so long. We lost family members to this. All we want is justice. That is not too hard to ask. Comparing from what you did to us, they never thought that we'd be standing here right now speaking. They thought we'd be 6 feet under. But no, we're here.
That's right.
We have a voice. We never have a voice in 89.
Still we rise.
You know? Every time when I see my family talk and all our families, it breaks my heart. This is
take your time, brother.
Oh,
take
right.
your time.
I'm all right.
You're here with you.
I'm all right.
You're
with
you, brother. You got your back.
You ain't alone.
Yeah. Blasio, just follow your word. You said that this was an injustice. You said you would settle this in 1 week. Like Roger said.
Over 100 days.
Not good with math, but it's been 100 days and counting.
Yeah.
We just topped this. We just want this to stop. Not just for us, but every young black and brown kid that's still going through this right now. We see ourselves through the youth because we lost ours. We're going to keep fighting. We keep fighting. We keep fighting until infinity.
That's right. Yay.
All right. All right. I'll just talk loud. Brothers and sisters, thank you for coming out. It's an honor to be here today.
Yeah, Ray.
My message really goes to de Blasio, because he said it was going to be a swift settlement. Right. He said this was an injustice.
Right.
He said, corporation council doesn't tell me what to do.
Right.
Doesn't tell the mayor what to do. The mayor tells them what to
that's
do.
Right. That's right.
Right?
Yeah, so, I heard him say it.
That's the truth.
He has a lot of promises to fulfill. He has fulfilled firefighters and you know, stop and frisk, which is awesome. But what about us?
That's right.
Are we going to be the kids that's going to be left behind?
No.
No,
no you won't.
No.
No, you won't.
You know, and so this is the dilemma that we deal with now. We're looking, like Kevin said, we're looking for closure. That scar isn't fully healed. And it will not be healed until this case is closed. Now, does it mean that, you know, the chapter of Century Bar Five will be over? We're going to fight something else. We'll fight something else because this stuff keeps happening over and over and over again.
Right.
And when does it stop? We have the power of the vote. We put people in position, right? And we hold them accountable. And once they get in a position, they forget.
That's right.
So we got to constantly remind them. You have a job to fulfill. You have obligations to us, the people, right? And you know, one thing that I look forward to is that we're going to be here. We're not going anywhere. We're going to fight. De Blasio, it's getting hot. Summer's coming.
Yes.
The crowd will get bigger.
That's
there will be more injustices to fight. You're going to constantly see us. Please, let's move forward. Let's put an end to this saga once and for all. And we can go from there. And we can go on and we can finish fighting for Romali. Kamari,
right.
You know, Kamari
that's
Gray.
Right. That's right.
You know, and all these cases that of people who have been falsely convicted. They're saying that on an average, they're saying that according to statistics, we're looking to break the record of false convictions. We're looking to hit over 100. So that's going to be a big obstacle that the city has to look at and they have to fix. But that's not our fault.
That's right.
You got to blame those who were here and who messed all those cases up. Those are the ones you gotta blame. Those are the ones we gotta hold accountable.
Amen.
But we have to do our part. We have to come out and we have to rally together against all these injustices. We're here. We ask that you come out too. So de Blasio, get ready. You're gonna see us. It's gonna be a long, long summer. But we look forward to it.
Cut the ball, cut the check. Cut the ball, cut the check. Cut the ball, cut the check.
Cut the ball, cut the check. Cut the ball, cut the check.
Cut the ball, cut the check.
Man, oh man.
Who just thought about that?
I like that.
He needs the pay.
For far too long, we've been coming out to stuff like this. Not just for the CP5, but this spike wheels of justice keeps on rolling down the hill, and we're the ones, unfortunately, that's getting trampled.
Yup.
We need to stand and be counted like we are today, but we also need to make sure. So, let me just say it like this, right? The other day, somebody showed me the numbers. And these numbers clearly show who of the people of New York City voted for Mayor de Blasio. Overwhelmingly, it was black and brown. Overwhelmingly black and brown. We are people that are plugged in. We are people that when we hire someone for a position, we need for that position to speak to us, to speak to our issues, to heal the wounds that have been happening in our city for far too long. As I got ready to come down here today, I had to constantly remind myself that I was 15 when this happened. I look in the mirror today and I have gray hair in my beard. The other day I turned 40 years old. 40 years old. And still we're fighting against this injustice. I refuse to call it the criminal justice system. I call it the criminal system of injustice. And everybody knows me knows that that's what I say. It's been a long time before I put my pen to a piece of paper to write another poem. But yesterday it happened. Yesterday it came out as an ode to Langston Hughes. What happens to a justice delayed? It is denied. Is that what this is this time? Justice delayed, justice denied. Drying up like a grape in the sun, our indelible scars festering and running. After a justice delayed too long, eluding us like forgotten words to a song. We are struggling to put our lives back, resuscitating ourselves before we lie flat. A life that stank like rotten meat. No roses to smell, not sugary sweet. Eluding us like it's trying to escape. Unable to erase this label they put on us of rapist. I'm pissed as I carry this heavy load. I want to explode. What happens to a justice delayed? What happens? I'm so glad to see all your faces. Someone met me in the crowd that I hadn't seen since I was in high school. She used to be a great friend of mine, amongst others. But when I tell you this journey has been long, but listen, 25 years long, too long. And I don't know, y'all recognize the voice. That's my mama back there. That's my mama. How long?
Too long.
How long?
Too long.
How long?
Too long.
Cut the check.
Cut the check.
And listen, I'm not saying that because you're going to see me on the beach sipping Mai Tais talking about I made it. I'm saying that because we need this thing to be restored.
That's right.
You can't give us money at any dollar amount that's gonna give us our lives back. But you can try to make it better. And by making it better, that means that
cut the check.
Sister said it right, cut the check.
Cut the check.
You know, I wanna just say this last one too. Because I'm glad to see media out here. I'm glad to see that we're beginning to get some more positive, broad, instead of local media coverage. Because like I said before, the revolution will not be televised.
That's right, baby.
The revolution will not be televised. I can remember when that statement made me sad inside. Too young to be in it. Now I couldn't even see it. Why? Why couldn't the revolution be televised? The last poets, Gil Scott Heron. As I grew up, I began to see they left theirs, and I too wanted to leave a mark on history. A man in half, and I wanted to bask in that task that set men free. But a revolution, the revolution, is where I knew I had to be. The revolution will not be televised. They didn't want to display this victory of quote unquote lesser men. The revolution will not be televised. Smile, we know, because we are the revolution. Peace.
And straight ahead.